Hey friends, you're always hearing about online security attacks, compromised websites, and some go undetected. How can you protect your application from hackers and malicious traffic? Teresa and Sharad are here to show us how Web Application Firewall with Azure Front Door can help protect our web applications without compromising speed, today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. We're talking about Azure Front Door. Teresa and Sharad, how are you?
Very good, thank you.
Yeah, thanks for sharing this product with me. You know, I actually recently set up Azure Front Door and I'm excited to learn even more about it.
Great.
All right.
So today we're gonna talk about what are the recent updates from the last Azure Friday session we did about Azure Front Door. And then we'll talk mostly about the Web Application Firewall, which just went into general availability. Mm-hmm. So just a quick recap of what Front Door is. So one of the key things that Front Door provides is if your application is hosted in multiple regions, then unlike a typical DNS-based load balancing system, you can fail over near instantly from one region to another. So because there's no DNS TTL that gets cached or things like that, or we are an Anycast IP, so when things need to switch, the client doesn't see any changes happening. And behind the scenes, Front Door actually just switches over from, let's say, US West to UK South.
So staging.hanselman.com right now is a CNAME that goes to Azure Front Door. That DNS is going to be the same always.
Yes.
So if I fail over, I don't have to wait for the whole world's DNS to expire.
Yep. So we typically do demos that, we can fail over under 30 seconds from one region to another, and the client doesn't even see break-in connections because they're still connecting to the same Azure Front Door environment.
Nice.
Okay,
that's cool.
The next thing that we talk about is the path-based load balancing. So Azure Front Door is a layer 7 load balancer, so it's HTTP, HTTPS. So we can do based on paths, we can send it to one region versus the another region, or depending on how you've deployed your microservices in Azure or even not in Azure, even on other cloud providers or on-premise systems. So based on path, you can do load balancing between one versus the other. You can do active-active, you can do active-passive, or just based on microservices.
By the way, that's been hugely useful for me because I'm in the process of moving my system from an old virtual machine to multiple microservices, and I've got hanselman.com/blog/this/podcast/speaking, all of that running on one IIS that now is going to run in multiple app services, and I wanted to have in multiple locations and multiple regions, and the only thing that would give me what I needed was Front Door.
Thanks for that.
Yeah, it's working great.
So the next thing we introduced with Front Door, and which is now generally available, is the Web Application Firewall capabilities with Front Door. So that's, again, that's the new thing that we have talked. And we are investing very, very heavily in this space because we see the constant requirement from our customers coming and talking to us, okay, how can we improve the security from application? Because you're fronting all of the traffic. Is there any way I can protect? There are different scenarios for SQL injection, cross-site scripting, multiple other things. And the last thing, because Front Door is a content site acceleration and at the heart of it a CDN as well, we literally accelerate both your dynamic as well as your static content, so pulling from the origin. So as I mentioned, some of the new capabilities, GA for WAF capabilities, we have enabled URL redirect. That is, you can redirect HTTP to HTTPS traffic. You can also redirect from one domain to another. You can redirect on the paths. All those are very versatile capability that we've launched. Mm-hmm. We were not supporting Apex domains, so that was a very, very major pain point, something we heard enormously.
Can you explain what an Apex domain is?
So typically, let's say if you have a domain, hanselman.org or hanselman.net, that's an Apex domain. You typically have your users going to www.hanselman.com.
Was that in the old days called naked domains?
Yeah, the naked domains, root domains, Apex domains, it's just different.
It's all the same thing.
It's all the same thing.
Okay, that's good to know. And I actually have that, so I should make sure that my Front Door is correctly configured.
So the other thing, we have now got a bunch of new certifications like ISO and SOC, and we are working through getting a lot of these other certifications, important certifications. We'll also have a blog post about that, all these new certifications that Front Door has.
Cool.
Yeah.
So then WAF, you own the Web Application Firewall.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, so you mentioned you actually like to your blog site to be on Azure Front Door now. Have you tried WAF?
Well, so I looked at it, and I went as far as clicking and preparing the profiles and the policies, but I saw SQL injection. My site doesn't have SQL. I saw PHP. I don't run PHP. So I kind of thought maybe it's not for me.
All right, so the WAF capabilities actually have more than just known attack signatures such as SQL injection or cross-site scripting. Mm. It can also helps you from malicious bots. Let's say you know you have your website, yeah. and then there is somebody intentionally want to send you many, many requests to block legitimate users to view your awesome blog. In that case, you can definitely create customized WAF rules to block them.
Oh, you can
rate limit them.
So then maybe WAF is for me.
Yeah, we should try that.
For everybody who's running a website.
So really, so you think WAF should be turned on for anyone using Azure Front Door?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay. Absolutely. We can go through some scenarios of how do you set up WAF with Front Door to protect your web applications.
Let's do it.
So let's see. Let's go ahead and start to create a new WAF policy.
So here we have a front door set up. It's a very simple front door that we have. It's just going and pointing to an app service instance running in central US. Mm-hmm. And there are two routes, one that just redirects HTTP to HTTPS traffic, and the other one forwards it to this backend pool that I just mentioned.
Okay.
For all of the HTTPS traffic.
Think about this scenario as you have your blog site hosted at the app services. Now we have added Azure Front Door, so now your users across the globe can get to your site through Front Door. So the Front Door is a reverse proxy in front of your web applications. Mm-hmm. By design, we block everything but the web traffic to you.
Really? Now you had mentioned before that there are different existing policies like SQL injections and PHP and different WordPress and different things that are known. But like I've started to notice some, I think, naughty people trying to do posts and things, and errors are showing up in my logs, which makes me feel like maybe I need a custom policy.
Absolutely, absolutely. You can customize a policy, say, for my website, I only allow get method, I'm not going to allow post method. You can do that.
That's
so
cool.
Let's go through a scenario. First, let's see how do we find to define a WAF.
Okay.
Yep.
So here we go.
So on the marketplace, you can just go to Marketplace and click on search for Web Application Firewall. Okay. And it'll show you the entry. And just go and click Create.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So in the Create flow, you will see just a few clicks, and then define your resource group, and then define a policy name. A policy name is unique, so we do use that as a unique identifier, so it cannot be the same.
Okay.
We will let you know if somebody else used that name. And then, so here, and then you can go, if you go down in the managed rule set, so this is a pre-configured rule set, has about 9 groups, and those are identified as the top vulnerabilities for web applications defined by OWASP Top 10, so Open Web Application Security Project. Mm-hmm. So those are the known signatures. So we have them pre-configured for you, so you can easily have the default protection.
Now, I went through this process, and I was getting ready to turn them all on.
Yes.
And I was going to just turn it all on because I want to be extra safe. How do I make sure that one of them doesn't accidentally keep my site from working because maybe I have a strange URL and one of those policies thought I was a bad guy to
myself.
Right.
So usually when you've enabled a WAF, you can, there are two mode. If you go to the top, there is a prevention mode and detection mode.
Ah.
So you can initially because false positive is a real concern for a lot of application owners, right? So you can say, I'm going to enable everything in detection rule. Uh-huh. So then I can see. And then for each individual rule, you can disable it.
That's cool. OK, so then what prevented me from finishing and going, yes, I want all of this turned on, was not knowing that. So now I can turn everything on, go into detection mode, run for a week, see what false positives may have happened, and then kind of make my policy perfect just for me.
Absolutely, yeah. You should actually, that's what we recommend people to do.
Oh, great.
And also, even let's say you decided I'm comfortable enough to enable protection mode or prevent mode, and then one specific rule I'm not so sure, individual rule level, you can also do log.
Really?
Yes.
Yep.
You can log on.
So
cool. Let's see how easy to set it up. So here we have the default configuration enabled for you, and then go ahead, we can associate with a front door host. Mm-hmm. And then in there, basically, you will be able to choose the front door you set up. And right here, if you, to create, review and create, and that's the whole process for you. So
and
you
that's
actually,
it.
That's it. For time's sake, we're not gonna go create, and we're gonna go back to the one we already pre-created for
you. Okay, cool.
So here in this one, you can see there's global settings we mentioned about prevention and detection. Mm-hmm. And then there's also a global setting, say, for example, if there are certain match conditions match, mm-hmm. I don't want to block or I don't want to log. I actually want to redirect to a honeypot or somewhere I want to look what this particular traffic do.
Right.
You can do that. You can define what is the redirect URL you use.
Okay.
And then our default response code when we block is 403. You can say something else.
Yeah.
Because sometimes people actually say, I just want to say 200 so the people doesn't know I'm actually blocking. Mm. Right. So you could do that.
That's a good point.
And then you can customize your response body as well. So that's all for the managed rule space. So in a WAF policy consists of custom rules and managed or pre-configured rule set. Custom rules always have a higher priority. So we always run custom rules first. Mm-hmm. So here we have a few custom rules defined for you. Let's go through the user agent one. Because a lot of, if you heard about concerns on bot, so there is malicious bots, and a lot of malicious bots have some kind of signatures. A lot of time is in the user agent string. So in this particular case, we configure a custom rule to block a user agent that says, I'm suspicious.
Right.
So it's just
if
an example.
If the bad guy says bad guy, we should block him. Absolutely.
Yeah, so you can use other signatures.
That's here. A lot of flexibility.
Yes, so our core is a really flexible WAF rules engine. Mm-hmm.
And you were also mentioning about request method. So we also have capabilities to do request method based on query string, URI parameters, and several other options that you can define your match conditions based on.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And another custom rule I want to point to you is the rate limiting. So rate limiting is a conditional rate limiting I can define for my one page of my website, I can only allow you to do 5. If people do more than 5 per minute, I think it's suspicious. You can do that. It's another use case for rate limiting is to block volumetric attacks. So you can't just send me thousands of requests.
See,
from same
now case. You've got my brain thinking about all the things I could potentially do. For example, I'm having a problem with comment spam. I could start rate limiting the bad guys that are going and spamming me by saying this many posts over this amount of time is suspicious. I know you're excited to comment on my blog.
Yes.
Slow down.
Right. Yeah.
This is great.
Yeah. And if that particular spammer have any other signatures, any combination of HTTP parameters, you can specifically define a custom rule to block.
And I'm doing that outside the context of my blog. It's really, those are business rules that are in the front door space. I don't have to change any application code for any of these things.
Absolutely.
Catch it at the front door.
Yep. Yes.
Yep. That's fantastic.
Because front door is also, front door architecture is using Anycast, so it's always very close to the client. So we want to stop it as close as to the source without bringing all this traffic.
So I'm in West US too, and they're in Australia. You'll stop them before they even cross the
probably
coast.
Probably in Brisbane or Melbourne, Brisbane, Sydney, Perth. We have multiple
You're
locations. You'll
catch them before they leave the continent.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Yes.
You don't have to travel the waters.
That's great.
Yeah, I think that's all. We can show you the how it works. So we can, let's see.
Very briefly as we
Show briefly of how it did.
Yeah, so in this first case, let's say we were talking about the rate limit scenarios. So we have this example where we have rate limited as we were showing.
Yep.
So if we go here, we said 5, so I'll just do a refresh around 5 times. And you'll see that on the 6th or 7th attempt, I'm now blocked to go into that particular site. Correspondingly, there are several other rules, like for example, for cross-site scripting or SQL injection or local file, you can see in the URL that somebody's trying to access to the local file or something.
Yeah.
And it just blocks you from doing those kind of things as well.
Yeah. Let's quickly touch on what do you see. So we have metrics. It's fully integrated with Azure monitoring, so you can tell which rule is blocked and how many requests are blocked.
Right.
As far as log goes, it's fully integrated with log analytics. So you can use log analytics, or you can use a storage account, or you can use Event Hub. So here we just show you it is integrated with log analytics. So you can see what requests come, what rules were triggered.
Mm-hmm.
And it can be actually, you can actually create something like a Sentinel to do a SIEM integration. You can pop your events through log analytics through there
that's
as
really
well.
That's cool. It's not a black box. And that's one of the things, when we turn a feature like this on, when we as customers put something in front of our application, we don't want it to feel like a black box. And you're showing me that none of these things are black box. Every policy, every action that is taken is available to me to go and analyze and do the right thing.
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely.
And just one last thing, we are running all these powerful WAF rules and everything on your all the traffic that we're getting. But so here I have a sample. We are doing a side-by-side comparison going into the actual instance of Central US, the app service instance. And we're going to the root path itself. We are doing that 50 times. And we'll pull the root path, the base image, the root domain itself, and we'll go via front door on the left hand side, and it has the WAF enabled. There is no caching whatsoever, so it's just every time going to evaluating WAF rules, going to the back end, pulling the content and giving it back. So we'll just start both of these, and you'll see after a few seconds that front door. I mean, each of these instances, we are pulling around 9 KB of response size. And after a while, as the connections get warmed up, as we get more traffic, you'll see a significant acceleration. We're currently on the Microsoft's corporate network, so there's a lot of time it takes to exit our proxy networks. But yeah, you'll see that there'll be a significant improvement. Even for a 9 KB object pull on an average, we would be saving around 100 to 200 milliseconds on a per request basis.
Yep, and it looks like on the left, it's already 20% faster, just in the few little bits that you've done.
Yeah, so you can see we saved here around, so on an average for 9 KB, with front door, we were doing 432 milliseconds. On the right-hand side, we were taking around 570. So
the warmer it gets, the faster it gets.
That's because of the connection. Yeah, and considering on your left-hand side, going through front door, we actually do the full inspection. Every single rules, hundreds of rules, actually for WAF is done still faster than if you were to go to your website directly without any WAF protection.
All right. Well, I'm going to go and set this up right away.
Great. Thank you
so much for chatting with me. I'm learning all about Azure Front Door and WAF, and I'm going to go set this up right now today on Azure Friday.